infection. The acute respiratory infection, that is ARI, is an acute infection of any part of the respiratory tract and related structures including paranasal sinuses, middle ear and pleural cavity. It may cause inflammation of respiratory tract anywhere from nose to alveoli with a wide range of combinations of symptoms and signs. It includes all infections of less than 30 days duration, except the infection of the ear lasting less than 14 days only. The incidence of acute respiratory infections is highest in young children, especially below the age of 5 years, and decrease with in the increases of age of the children. What are the classifications of acute respiratory infections? The classification includes number 1 depending upon the site of infection, and number 2 depending upon the anatomical involvement of lung, and number 3 depending upon the severity of infection. The first of all, number 1, that is site of infection. The acute respiratory infection, it includes common cold, pharyngitis and otitis media, and 2 acute lower respiratory infection, this is include epiglottitis, laryngitis, bronchitis, bronchiolitis and pneumonias. This is lower respiratory tract infections. Second one is depending upon the anatomical involvement of lung. This classification include bronchopneumonia. In bronchopneumonia, there is a patchy involvement of the lungs, and lobar pneumonia, one or more lobe may be involved in this disease. Third one is pneumonitis or interstitial pneumonia. In pneumonitis, alveoli or interstitial tissue between them affected. And depending upon the severity of infection, the acute respiratory infections and pneumonia can be classified as follows, and it is also recommended by the WHO. For the children within 2 months to 5 years of the age. Number 1, no pneumonia. Number 2, pneumonia not severe. And number 3, severe pneumonia. And last one is very severe disease. It's all upon the manifestations and causative organism of the infection. For the infant less than 2 months of age, there is classification number 1, no pneumonia, then severe and very severe disease. Majority of ARI deaths in children are due to pneumonia. Pneumonia is the infection of lungs parenchymal tissues. There is a consolidation of alveoli or infiltrations of the interstitial tissues with inflammatory cells in pneumonia. Pneumonia may be as primary infection or may be in secondary to acute bronchitis or upper respiratory tract infections. The causative organism of the infections include the bacterial, viral, protozoal, and last one is miscellaneous causes may be present. In bacterial infection, the pneumococcus, staphylococcus and staphylococcus are the most. And then second, in viral, influenza, measles, chickenpox and respiratory syncytial virus are the most common causes of viral infections. And in protozoal infections, pneumocystis and Toxoplasma gonadii and Histolyca are the main protozoa to infections. And in miscellaneous causes, there may be aspiration pneumonia, that is amniotic fluid in newborn, vomiting, drowning on foreign body are the infants or young children, and chemical pneumonia due to kerosene or oil poison, kerosene oil poisoning. Then what are the clinical manifestations, that is sign and symptoms of the pneumonia or acute respiratory infections. The sign and symptoms, the clinical features of ARI depend upon the age of the children and the site and severity of the infections, and causative organism with general health and associated medical conditions of the infections. The common manifestations of acute respiratory infections are nasal discharge, मैलेज, एनोरेक्सिया, सोर थ्रोट, इरिटेबिलिटी, चेस्ट पेन, चिल्स, टेकिकार्डिया एंड रेस्पिरेटरी डिस्ट्रेस एंड ईयर प्रॉब्लम्स मे बी इंक्लूडेड. देन अपर रेस्पिरेटरी इन्फेक्शंस मे प्रेजेंट एज ड्राई कफ विथ नेजल डिस्चार्ज, purulent nasal discharge and inflammation of tonsils, pharynx and glands. Then acute bronchitis usually present with fever and dry cough, and acute bronchiolitis is manifested as severe illness with severe dyspnea and cough is either absent or mild to moderate. Fever 15 days usually present in acute bronchiolitis infections. Then on the basis of WHO recommendations, the features of lower respiratory infections may be grouped as follows. In lower respiratory infections, only cough and cold includes no pneumonia. There is no pneumonia diagnosed when child have only cough and cold. And if there is fast breathing, that is increased respiratory rate with the presence of cough and cold indicates pneumonia but not severe. For fast breathing is diagnosed when the respiratory rate is according to the age of the baby. The age of 1 to 5 years of age, there is 40 breaths as per minute or more than it. It is called fast breathing. And in the age of 2 to 12 months of age, the 50 breaths per minute or it's more. It is diagnosed as a fast breathing, and at the age of 2 months of baby, 60 breaths per minute or more than it is called fast breathing according to the age of the baby. Then chest indrawing and with or without fast breathing indicates severe pneumonia. If there is chest indrawing with or without fever, with fast breathing, it is indicates the severe pneumonia in the baby. Other sign which may present in severe pneumonia include nasal flaring. One was the chest indrawing, second is the nasal flaring, third is the cyanosis, fourth one is the grunting and wheezing of soft muscles, noise due to swallowing and narrowing of the small airways of the lungs. It is all signs and symptoms of the severe pneumonia in the baby. And very severe disease is indicated by the presence of danger signs like inability to drink, excessive drowsiness, stridor in calm child, or grunting, wheezing, or cyanosis, apnea, fever, hypothermia or hyperthermia, abdominal distension with convulsions. These all symptoms are indicate very severe disease is acute respiratory infection in children. The diagnostic measures include careful examination and of clinical features, detailed history and auscultation of chest sound of diagnosis of ARI and pneumonia. Only in complicated cases, blood investigations and chest x-ray can be done. Then complications. What are the complications of the acute respiratory infections? It includes emphysema, atelectasis, emphyma, lung abscess or pneumothorax or pneumococcal infections. Then otitis media, chronic sinusitis and congestive cardiac failure or respiratory failure may be in late complications or complications of the acute respiratory infection. Then what are the management of acute respiratory infection? In the management of acute respiratory infection include the treatment depends upon the type of illness and severity of infections with associated complications. The standard treatment for children for ARI is recommended by NRI, National ARI Control Program, especially for primary health care setting is number one. The child with no pneumonia can be treated at home with home remedies for symptomatic treatment like fever and cough. and does not require antibiotic therapy. Number 2, the child with pneumonia can be treated in outpatient department, that is OPD, with oral antibiotics and other symptomatic treatment like antipyretic and bronchodilators. And third one is, the child with severe pneumonia should be hospitalized urgently and requires antibiotics with symptomatic treatment. And last one is, the child with very severe disease needs immediate hospitalization and to be treated with parenteral antibiotics, oxygen therapy, antipyretics, bronchodilators and other supportive measures. The supportive general measures include bed rest, propped up position, warmth, isolation, suction of and remove the secretions from the tracheobronchial tree. Adequate fluid maintenance and dietary maintenance is necessary, and humid environment, hygienic measures, clearing of air passage and nose, monitoring the child's condition like vital signs, oxygen saturation and pulse oximetry, and postural drainage should be checked. In complicated cases, surgical interventions may be needed like aspiration in case of emphysema and closed chest drainage in case of pneumothorax and ventilatory support in the case of respiratory failure. The prognosis is good if the early diagnosis and early initiation of treatment is in appropriate time to be taken. The nursing assessment or nursing management includes: determine the severity of infection and respiratory problem, an initial history of present complications and history of illness help the assess the needed of priority interventions. Then duration of illness, age of child, previous illness, presence of associated symptoms and any treatment taken before are very important, along with routine history and physical examinations. And respiratory pattern, associated sign and symptoms, features of complications to be evaluated carefully. What are the nursing diagnosis of the cases of acute respiratory infections? The nursing assessment helps to document nursing diagnosis. It should be reported clearly because it is very essential for further nursing management. The common nursing diagnosis for the child with ARI can be: number 1, ineffective airway clearance related to inflammation or obstruction. Number 2, ineffective breathing pattern related to inflammatory process of lungs. Number 3, fluid volume deficit related to fever, anorexia and vomiting of the child. Number 4, fatigue related to increased work of breathing or fever of. Number 5th, anxiety related to respiratory distress or hospitalization of the child. And parental role conflict related to illness of the child. Then nursing interventions. In general, nursing interventions for the child with ARI include provision of bed rest with comfortable position, administration of oxygen therapy and clearing the airway passages, maintenance of warm and humid, well-ventilated environment, maintenance of adequate hydration and oral parenteral fluid for recording of intake output chart, and provision of adequate nutrition by the breastfeeding or dietary intake, practicing safe measures to prevention of accidents and other infections, monitoring the child's condition continuously with immediate recording, and provision of frequent change of position, that is 2-hourly change of position, chest physiotherapy and postural drainage may be useful to prevent complications and for early recovery of the patient. Then giving tepid response to treat the fever, maintenance of personal hygiene and clean elimination, explanation and reassurance to the parents, and arrangement to play material in recovery phase of diversion and recreation, and to reduce anxiety and tension related to hospitalization of the children, and planning for discharge from hospital and home care. Health education to be parent and family members for home care and follow-up and prevention of further attacks. Then preventive measures of ARI. There are some preventive measures should be taught to the parents and family members, that is, ARI can be prevented by modification of risk factors related to respiratory infections and other disease. Family members should be and parents should be needed to inform about the following, that is good hygiene practice related to personal and environment hygiene and appropriate handling and disposal of respiratory secretions of the infected individual and isolation of the infected person, maintenance of nutritional status, immunization to be completed as per the schedule, and use of home remedies for cough and cold like tulsi, honey, ginger, hot drinks, etc., and regular health checkups for the detection and deviation from normal health and growth and development. Nutrition status and associated problems should be checked up, and avoiding harmful practice related to child care during the illness or wellness. Thank you.